Hello guys, I hope you all are doing good. I am Vishali Kikan and we are discussing the VLSI technology. In that, we are discussing the chemical mechanical polishing or the CMP, and this is the last video in the CMP series. I hope you all have watched all of the previous videos on the chemical mechanical polishing. If not, it is highly recommended that you go back and watch the previous videos on CMP first and then come to this video. So today in this video, we are going to talk about the process issues. So this is a really important video. So now the CMP process is a relatively new process as compared to the other VLSI fabrication processes. So it is a very limited process which is having very limited details with it which are known and which are practically available, right? So the main concern for the CMP processes are the polishing rate. Right, we need to increase the polishing rate, the planarization capability. We want highly planar structure within the die uniformity. We want higher within the die uniformity. Within the wafer uniformity must also be high. Wafer to wafer uniformity must also be high. Removal selectivity depends upon the particular application, what we want, and the defect and the contamination control must also be very high. The contamination control must be high, defect must be very low. So these are the various concerns which are present on the various CMP processes. Coming to the polishing rate, so now polishing rate is affected by the downward force pressure, right? So we are putting a down force pressure on the wafer holder. I have already told you about the hardware in which I have talked about the various components. I hope you remember we were putting a down force pressure on the wafer holder. So if I increase or decrease the down force pressure, my polishing rate is going to increase or decrease. So it is directly proportional to the pressure, right? I have already told you about this. It is dependent upon the pad hardness, pad condition, applied slurry, as well as it depends upon the rotation speed. Okay, so I can change all of them and I can find out what is the best polishing rate that we are getting by adjusting all of them. So now coming to the planarization. Planarization is the capability which determines that how much planar my structure is, how much roughness I have removed. So it is determined by the stiffness as well as the surface condition of the polishing pad. If I have the thicker and if I have the harder polishing pad, okay, and if I have the polishing pad which is rotating at a high speed, I will be getting a best planarization, right? So now coming to the uniformity. Uniformity is going to be affected by the polishing pad condition. It is going to be affected by the downforce pressure, the relative speed of the wafer to the polishing pad as well. So it depends upon the curvature of the wafer as well, which is related to the film stress. So all of these parameters are going to affect the uniformity. Downforce pressure distribution among all of them is the most important knob to control the CMP uniformity, right? So if I have higher downforce pressure, then how I can change the uniformity? You have to tell me. We have already discussed about it. So you can put it in the comment. So now coming to the removal selectivity. So it is actually controlled with the help of slurry. So if I change the chemistry of the slurry, the selectivity is also going to change. So it is also related to the pattern density. If I have a denser pattern, the removal rate will be lesser, right? So it is determined by the designed layout as well. Coming to the defects. So there are many different kind of defects. We have talked about them, that how we have various different kind of defects which are generated due to slurry, due to the scratches, and we have further other defects as well. Now how we can control these defects, that is really important. What hardness of the polishing pad that I have to take, right? What kind of slurry that I have to take, what kind of post CMP cleaning that I have to do. So this is again a very important concern that we have. So it is going to relate with many different process parameter as well, right? So now coming to the contamination control. So how I am going to control the contamination? So we are going to isolate the chemical mechanical polishing bay from other processing areas. We are going to do this process in a isolated place, right? After that, we are going to restrict the movement between the CMP bay and the other area so that we will not be having any other particulate contamination. We can have a dedicated copper CMP tool as well so that the copper contamination of the silicon wafer will be avoided. Copper contamination is going to degrade the performance of the wafer very effectively. So I don't want my contaminants to be causing some major process issues on the wafer. So I can use the copper in a separate way and I can avoid the copper contamination. So copper contamination can cause the unstable performance of the MOSFET and it can ruin the IC chip overall. It can reduce the overall yield of the IC. So if slurry has spilled, it is going to immediately cause very significant errors or significant defects in the IC, which we have to control. So if the slurry has spilled, it is very, very important to immediately wash and clean it thoroughly, right? The dried slurry also leaves huge amount of tiny particles, so which is easy to airborne and it can come as a source of particle contaminant. So we have to avoid the spilling of the slurry. We have to handle the slurry very carefully. Now coming to the future trends. So in the future, as I have already told you in the previous video, we are moving towards the copper. So when the metallization is done with the copper CMP is an inherent step. So the most widely used CMP is the copper CMP. So copper and low dielectric constant interconnection would be available in the future and we can use the low dielectric CMP as well. Copper and the barrier layer CMP process with high selectivity to low dielectric constant material would be done. So now coming to the DRAM application, CMP process involved with the polysilicon and high dielectric material will be taken place in the future. So this is how we can apply this thing in the future. So now coming to the summary. So the main application of the CMP are the dielectric planarization and the bulk film removal. We can do this CMP in the STI, PMD, IMD planarization for the planarization of the tungsten plugs, for dual damascenes of the copper interconnection as well. We require CMP when I have lesser than 0.25 micrometer feature patterning due to the depth of focus requirement. Now coming to the advantage, it is giving me higher resolution patterning, it is giving me higher yield, low defect density. So I have talked about the CMP system, which consists of wafer carrier polishing pad on a rotating platen and a pad conditioner and a slurry delivery system. All of them contains or consists the CMP hardware. So oxide slurry. So in the oxide slurry, we are using the alkaline slurry, which is having the pH in between 10 to 12 with colloidal suspension of silica abrasives. Now coming to the tungsten slurries, which are acidic solution, which is having pH in between 4 to 7, which contains alumina abrasives. Copper slurry will be having acidic with alumina abrasives. So the important factor of the CMP processes are polishing rate, planarization capability, selectivity, uniformity defect and the contamination control. Polishing rate is affected by downforce pressure, pad stiffness, pad surface condition, relative speed between pad and wafer and slurry type. CMP uniformity affect by the downforce pressure distribution, pad stiffness and the pad condition. The removal of selectivity is mainly determined by the slurry chemistry. We can change the slurry chemistry and we can change the selectivity. Oxide CMP process will be having silica particles forming the chemical bond with the surface atom, and this is how we are going to abrade or remove the material from the surface, right? The hydroxyl ions were making the bond with the silica and this is how we were abrading or removing the layer with the help of the silica particles. The two metal removal mechanism in the metal CMP process were wet etching and the passivation abrade. So one was purely chemical reaction and another we were using chemical plus mechanical reactions, right? So now coming to the endpoint detection, we had talked about the optical endpoint detection in which we were doing the thickness measurement for the dielectric film, and we were doing the reflectivity measurement for the metal film. We were calculating where we will be getting constructive interference, where we will be getting the destructive interference. And the next endpoint can be detected with the help of motor current. Post CMP cleaning reduces the defect and improves the yield. And this is how I can say post CMP cleaning is a very important technique. So these are the references. Some very amazing books which you can read for your future references, for future studies as well. If you have any doubt, you can put the doubt in the comment and I'm going to revert as soon as possible. I hope you like this session. If you like it, please push the like button. Give your feedback. That is the utmost thing that is required, because without your feedback, it is very difficult for me to get connected to you, right? So I will be waiting for your feedback. Plus, you can connect with me on any other social media site as well, right? And if you like this video, you have to push the like button, subscribe to the channel, and also do share it with your friends. Thank you so much.